The reason why I joined FPL was because I wanted something more than the math and science that I was getting from going to school. At the end of the day, everything you learn is just theory unless you put your education to practical use. This is where becoming a leader comes in. By going into the communities, by doing health research, and by advocating for health and social justice, you can speak for those who cannot speak for themselves.
The purpose of our program is to develop more homegrown, high-quality physician leaders who serve the community with social responsibility in order to achieve optimal community health, wellness, and healthcare access for all residents in our region. Whether a junior or senior in high school, or an undergraduate or medical student, each participant of the Future Physician Leaders program will be part of a lifetime network of healthcare leaders and professionals. We started the program in 2009 after I spoke at different high schools throughout the Coachella Valley, and after every talk there was always a student who came in telling me that they want to do exactly what I'm doing in terms of being a physician and coming back to the community and serving. And I saw the same passion in their eyes that I had in my eyes when I was their age. And I saw that same desire to be a physician. And we need this because we live in one of the worst healthcare crises and most underserved areas in the state of California. There is only one physician per 9,000 residents throughout the eastern Coachella Valley and also the western Coachella Valley in Desert Hot Springs. We need more physicians to fill in the physician shortage that we have. In order to fully support and prepare our students, our program consists of three components: didactic, community service and leadership, and the summer shadowing rotation program. The didactic component consists of lectures, workshops, and group discussions. Over the course of 6 weeks, our lecture series include a broad range of topics and guest speakers, including community leaders, community activists, and medical practitioners and healthcare professionals. Our guest speakers give valuable advice from their own personal experiences throughout their years of service. Our students are engaged in thoughtful, insightful thinking, where they evaluate their purpose and their role in serving the community as well. One of the core elements of the didactic component is the networking opportunities.
Having the dinner, seeing other doctors, communicating with them, that was a great process, that was great. There was different doctors, you know, you can talk to about like what they do in their practice. Like, you know, I interned with Dr. Nicole Ortiz, who's a naturopathic doctor. She works with natural medicines, and I got to see what natural medicines she used. But never know that there would be I didn't know there was naturopathic doctors that work with natural medicines. She taught me a lot, like I saw what she did in her office, and FPL helped me do that.
The community service and leadership component is the heart and soul of this program. We aim to expose our students to the virtues of service and actively engage them in leadership roles to improve healthcare access and community health. They have given health talks in their communities, perform diabetes screenings, and also participated in free flu vaccines throughout the region. They have worked with medical students to design and implement a community research project, as well as community health education projects throughout the area.
The shadowing component of FPL gives you the medical experience, but also gives you the opportunity to create long-lasting relationships with physicians. doctors during the entire shift mentor you and give you advice on what to do to get to medical school and what clubs you should be in and what to do once you're in medical school.
Our students shadow a lot of different types of physicians in different clinical settings. For example, we have them in the primary care clinics with family physicians and internists and geriatricians. We also have them in the emergency department with emergency physicians. We have them in the operating rooms with general surgeons and neurosurgeons and cardiothoracic surgeons. And we also have them in the hospital with hospitalists and internists, radiologists, and a whole lot of different types of physicians and nurse practitioners throughout the entire Coachella Valley. The idea is for the students to develop mentorship relationships with other physicians that will inspire them to continue their path of being that future physician leader.
Anyone can be a leader, and we need more leaders in the Coachella Valley because there's a huge population in need of your help. They depend on you to show up, and they depend on you to do well. This program can provide you with all of these opportunities. And this program can teach you how to become a leader.
I want to give a heartfelt thank you to all our different partners, our administrative assistants, our physicians, our nurses, our nurse practitioners, our hospital and clinic leaders, as well as all the representatives of the healthcare system in the Coachella Valley for the time and energy that you have put in for our students. Your investment with this program, with your talent, your skill, and your motivation, will lead to a better and healthier Coachella Valley. And I thank you so much for facilitating our students' dream of becoming that physician leader, and community advocate.